to mandatorily allow public participation in the formulation of the annual budget and for other related matters. Honourable members will recall that the bill was read the first time on Wednesday, 25th May 2016. I now invite Honourable Iduma Igarwe to move that the bill be read a second time.
My name is Igarwe Iduma Enwo. I represent the good people of Afiko North, Afiko South Federal Constituency. I'm proudly a Bonyan. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, I rise to move that a bill for an act to alter Section 81 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, to mandatory allow public participation in the formulation of the annual budget and for other related matters be read a second time. I so move. 81 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as amended so as to allow critical segments of the Nigerian public to make inputs into the budget formulation process. More specifically, Mr. Speaker, the bill seeks to add a new subsection, that is subsection 81.5, to read that, and I quote, the public shall make inputs into the preparation of an appropriation bill or a supplementary appropriation bill before it is laid before the National Assembly. Mr. Speaker, it is very important to state here that this bill recognizes and respects the fact that the budget formulation process is entirely the prerogative of the executive. What this bill merely seeks to do is to open a window, no matter how small, for a more participatory and inclusive process, especially as this administration seeks to migrate from an envelope system to a zero-based system of budgeting, in line with global best practices. Mr. Speaker, as we all know, the budget formulation process is undertaken by the Budget Office of the Ministry of National Planning. The consensus of opinion is that the interaction between the Budget Office and the various ministries, departments, and agencies is not deep enough to capture the basis and justification for budget selection. In fact, Mr. Speaker, in the just concluded 2016 budget, an NGO called the Citizens' Wealth Platform identified projects totaling a mind-boggling sum of 680 billion naira as frivolous, inappropriate, unclear, and wasteful expenditure. The result is endless controversy over the budget and missed allegations of budget padding, cutting and pasting of figures by a so-called tiny cabal. Mr. Speaker, what this bill seeks to achieve is in tandem with the aspirations of our legislative agenda, the legislative agenda of this 8th Assembly, which has been adopted as a working document by this Honorable House. Mr. Speaker, I refer with all respect to our draft legislative agenda, page 20, and I quote, it's headed Integrity of Project Selection Process. It says that our commitment to reform of the budget process should consider the integrity of the project selection process in the annual budget estimates submitted to the National Assembly by the President, a mechanism that makes the process of budget selection more transparent, equitable, professional, accountable, and needs-based shall be put in place with the cooperation of the executive. The budget process should include basis and justification for project selection, end of quote. Mr. Speaker, that is an item from our own legislative agenda, the legislative agenda of this 8th Assembly. Mr. Speaker, this laudable item in our legislative agenda was very recently adopted and amplified by no less a person than the presidential spokesperson, Malam Garba Shehu, when earlier this week, in a chat with the press, stated, and I quote, The President is determined to make the budget process more transparent and participatory, to re-engineer the entire process of governance for the benefit of the ordinary citizens. End of quote. Mr. Speaker, it is very obvious from this statement from no less a person than the President's own spokesperson that the position of this administration is in tandem with our legislative agenda to see that a transparent and inclusive budget process, which is a good process and is essential to facilitating investment, comes into place in this regime, in this administration. Mr. Speaker, considering the fact that Nigeria's greatest asset is its people, there is no reason whatsoever excluding input from them in the decision of what goods and services they will need within the financial year. This bill, therefore, provides the legal and institutional framework for ensuring popular participation in the budget formulation process. Mr. Speaker, without belaboring the matter, I will finalize by saying that it is important to emphasize the point that this bill does not in any manner whatsoever usurp the role of the budget consideration and approval, which is the exclusive preserve of the National Assembly, as guaranteed by Section 59 of our Constitution. The public participation envisaged by this bill is restricted only to the budget formulation stage, which is the exclusive of the executive. So it does not extend beyond the formulation stage to the consideration stage, which is our own preserve. Mr. Speaker, since this bill seeks to alter a section of the Constitution, I crave this esteemed House and the support of all of us, Mr. Speaker, and relying on Section 13, Rule 1-3 of our bills, of our rules, to commit this bill to the Special Committee of this House on Constitution Alteration for further consideration. I so move, Mr. Speaker.
The question is that against it, say nay. Eyes have it. Clerk is invited to read the long title of the bill.
Honorable Speaker, honorable members, the bill for an act to alter Section 81 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria 1999 to mandatorily allow public participation in the formulation of the annual budget of other related matters. Second reading.